Meow. Oh my goodness. First prize, Science Duck 13. That was quick.
Aw, thanks for the hearts.
Hey guys who are just joining us. Hi. We are just sitting here and chilling for probably... Hey, Dylan Thomas. How are you? I love seeing familiar usernames pop up. We're just sitting here looking at my cat for a minute until a few more people join us. OMG the lag. Oh no, is it bad? Are we okay? Let me see if I can flip this camera around, which apparently is a double tap. We'll make that happen.
Hey, oh goodness. Oh, that's very close. We're going to move that away slightly. Hey guys, good morning. It's still early. This is my Where I Write chat for Wattpad in conjunction with Where I Write. And we're just going to hang out for a few minutes. Hey, Dylan. It's good to see you, man. We're just going to hang out for a few minutes until we get a few more people on board, because it takes a few people to catch up. And it is 8 a.m. here on the Gold Coast, which is really super early. And I am a little bit tired. Hey guys who are just joining us, just explaining that we're going to hang out for a few minutes as it's not quite time to begin. And then we'll have a chat and look at Where I Write, which I don't think is particularly exciting. There's a few things that I can tell you that hopefully will keep it a bit interesting. I don't know why there's so much lag. I have really good service here. There's not much I can do about it, unfortunately. So we'll just have to see how we go this morning. Good morning, everyone, or good evening, depending on where you are. I think, is it the East Coast of America? You guys should be about 6 p.m. right now. So it's 8 a.m. in the morning here in Australia. And it's light outside, but it's really wet today where I am, which is on the Gold Coast. So we're just hanging out for a couple of minutes and waiting before we begin my Where I Write chat for Wattpad, which should be awesome. If you guys have questions at any stage, feel free to ask them. Apparently there's a bit of a lag. Sorry about that. And feel free to tap the screen at any stage and show me some love. That's where the love hearts come from if you haven't used Periscope before. 11 p.m. in Ireland. Oh my gosh. You guys are a really long way behind us. That's amazing. I love it. Yeah. It's 8 a.m. Sunday morning here. So I had a bit of a late Saturday night. So it's good to have you here. It shall not load. Yeah. Sorry, Science Duck 13. I'm not sure I can help with the lag. So that's okay. We'll just hang out here and see if maybe the lag gets better. I don't know if it's you guys or me. Ah, Little Missy Pie. That sounds like a familiar name. Good morning. All right, guys. We'll kick off in about two more minutes. Apparently the lag is really bad today for some of you. And I don't know if that is my service or if that's just the general working function of Periscope. So how I anticipate this morning going down is I'll show you my desk, which is super exciting. And then you guys can ask some questions and I will wrap it up after that. So we'll hang out for a couple more minutes. Oh, there we go. Science Duck says we're getting better. Good. My kitchen is apparently a dead zone, so I'm going to try and stay away from there and stay closer to this side of the room, and hopefully that'll make things easier. Good morning, good evening, good afternoon, depending where in the world you are. It's great to have you here. I'm Kate. I'm also known as Blonde and Dangerous, for those of you who know me on Wattpad. Or maybe you're just a random that's popped in off Periscope, because that's kind of fun to do as well. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to flip the camera around and show you guys my desk.
I'm not sure how thrilling this will be. This is my little writing corner here in this part of my house, and I made a really deliberate choice when I decided where to set up my desk in my house, because I actually have an enormous spare room. Yeah, hashtag Team Wattpad, definitely. I actually have a massive spare room in my house. It's a bit hard to see. It's down the end there with the roof on it. And I had a deliberate choice whether I could set up my office in a really isolated place or I could do it out here. So this is my family and my living area. And the reason that I made that deliberate choice was because I really wanted to be still a part of family life. And I know that there is kind of this thing with writers that, oh, we have to get like really dark and mysterious and deep in our cave in order to do any work. But for me, my life is really busy. So it's more a case of when can I find, you know, 2 minutes in between dishes and washing and everything else to rush over and just get some words out. So it doesn't necessarily have to be a big romantic thing that was sort of locked away in a tower. And I encourage anyone who enjoys writing and wants to write is literally just write, like find whatever time you can and get in front of your keyboard. And I think that's a hell of a lot easier to do when your keyboard is somewhere accessible and not trapped away. So this is my little working space. Guys, I can see some of you dropping in and out. I'm really sorry about the quality this morning. And we'll just push on through. I might relocate to a different part of the house after this. We'll see if that makes a difference. So for anyone interested in the writing process, I keep a whiteboard beside my desk. So this is where I'm tracking a print novel that I'm literally going to finish this weekend. It's pretty exciting. And it's a print novel that's coming out under a different name. So it won't be under Kate Squires and it won't be under Blonde and Dangerous either. So this is coming out for a publisher here in Australia, so Pan Macmillan. And so on this, I've got my timeline tracked up the top for the novel. I've got characters and character traits down below, which just helps me to remind the things. And this is a full chapter breakdown of the back half of the book. So we talk in writing whether some people are like plotters, so whether you plot characters, chapters, and what's going to happen next, or whether you just kind of throw yourself into it and see where things go. So I tend to lightly plot. I don't do too much. Hey, cat girl. I do a little bit. So I have like a basic kind of chapter breakdown of what that looks like. And actually on the back of this piece of paper, I know some of you are Wattpad readers, that's the chapter breakdown for Tender at the moment where it sits. But I don't want to show you too much because I know there are still people reading it. Why did I go with a different name? That's a really good question. Dylan, I went with a different name. It's going to be an open pseudonym, which basically means everyone will know that it's me, but I'm just writing under a different name. Because when I write romance, which I do for Wattpad, and when I write erotica, which I've also done for Wattpad with 30 Layers and 30 Days, which has just come out this week, when I do that, there's a certain expectation that there will be a happy ending. So that's pretty much the founding part of what we do in romance, is a happily ever after. This book that I've been working on, that will actually be coming out on bookshelves around Australia, is not a happily ever after situation. So this is, it sounds strange, but the pseudonym is actually to protect you guys as my readers. And I do that because, you know, I don't want you reading something that I've done and being like, oh my God, this is nothing like what I normally enjoy, from Kate. So it'll still be my first name. I'll still be Kate, but the last name will be different. And I'll give you guys a heads up as we get closer to release, if that's something you're still interested in reading. Hey, anyone who's just joined us, I think I just missed a question there. Somebody asked something about Inspire. If you want to type that again, because they don't stay on my screen for very long. And remember, you can give hearts at any stage just by tapping on the screen. And hopefully the quality is not too bad. I'll relocate in a minute. So this is my little desk. I literally haven't cleaned up too much because I like to just show you guys how it actually is. Who do I inspire the most? As in, who do I try to inspire, or who am I inspired by? We can clarify that. That'd be awesome. And here's my desk and my computer. And normally, there is a giant white fluffy cat lurking around here somewhere who basically hassles me the entire time that I'm writing. Interested in... Let me know, Dylan. I'm not sure what you're interested in. All things. I was going to show you this. Like, who am I inspired by? As in writers, I'm guessing, cat girl. Writers who inspire me, I read a lot. You know, for romance novels, there's a figure running around that says that romance people who read romance generally will burn through about 3 to 4 books a week. And when I'm not writing, that's definitely me. Should I walk you guys over here and show you my bookshelf? One of my bookshelves. Hey, Stephen. Welcome. So Jodi Picoult is a huge influence. Jodi Picoult, sorry, is a huge influence on my women's fiction that I write. So that's one of the ones that I've recently sold, and I'll be in print in a book pretty similar to this in about a year, which is cool. So she's a huge influence of mine. I read kind of a bit of everything when I'm not just reading romance. I'm a huge fan of Chuck Palahniuk, if anyone's read any of his work. It's really dark, but it's amazing. Yeah, the Harrys are down there as well. That's my Lord of the Rings fantasy kind of shelf living down the bottom. I've got a lot of books on dolphins and seals and different bits and pieces, and my Stephen King shelf as well. I am inspired by a bit of everything. I love young adult fiction as well. I think there's something really fun and pure about reading something that's been done for younger readers. And I like darker and I like older stuff too. So about 2 years ago, when I started getting really serious about my writing journey, I decided to write a bit of everything, and I literally did. And if you look at my Wattpad profile, you'll see a bit of that. There's some erotica and there's some fantasy stuff on there, and there's some adventure romance, and I wrote a bit of everything just to see what really landed and what people wanted to read. Because I'm a professional, I write content for a living, so I can write literally almost anything. But it was what was going to be of interest to people, and so that's where I started. I just want to show you guys this, and I'll flip the camera around, take us to a different part of the house, and hopefully the light will improve. This is my first ever check that I received for selling a piece of writing. So I'm a paid content writer, but it's a little bit different to get paid for something that you created yourself. And I sold this about a year and a bit ago to Reader's Digest. And they paid me $150 for a little piece that I wrote, which was really cool. But they've spelt my name wrong, which is awesome. So from humble beginnings. So it's really nice to, to have a career where I'm paid to write, but also, I have a day job as well. So if you're thinking about making writing a career, and I've given this advice before to people on Wattpad, that you really would look to have a career in the meantime that will allow you to support what you do. All right, I'm going to walk through the house. There may be a bit of lag and drama as the camera struggles to catch up, and I'm hoping the reception will actually be better down here. This is my second most favorite place to write in the entire world. It is a swingy egg chair that lives down in my bedroom, and it is my safe little hidey hole from the world. And we're gonna sit here and we're gonna have a quick chat, and then I'll let you guys go. So if anyone has any other questions, let me know. If you've enjoyed what you've seen so far, tap the screen, leave me some hearts. It's been great having you guys here. Scarlet Bloom, will I be continuing Ocean Eyes soon? I'm glad you like it. It's one of my favorites. I didn't get a chance to show you guys in the corridor pictures of Ben, who is my husband and the love of my life, and I working with dolphins and seals. So that was where the inspiration for that story came from. Yes, I do want to continue that story, is the short answer to that. So it's a big priority for me to make sure that I always have free stuff for you guys to read on Wattpad, especially as I start publishing more stuff soon. I'm hopeful, Scarlett. The plan is this weekend I'm going to finish my big serious commercial novel. I need to edit it next week, which is, for any of you who are writers, that's a pretty in-depth process as well. And then I will send it off, and then I will have all my time back. So starting in August, Scarlett, hopefully you'll be seeing maybe a chapter a fortnight of that one. Just trying to gauge interest between that. I originally wrote it for Harlequin, so I'm trying to fit one of their briefs to see, what they will publish. So I'm published through Harlequin Online Australia. Lily, how do I come up with the titles? titles are really hard. And sometimes
you get it right and sometimes you just don't. So 30 Lays in 30 Days, I just kind of wrote that as a silly title because the book is meant to be kind of silly and sexy and fun, and I think the title reflects that. When it's been published now, the publishers kept it. They didn't change the title, so that was really cool. Erotic Island, which I, you know, tap the screen and leave me a heart if you read Erotic Island while it was around, that title, the publisher decided they wanted to change because they felt that having the word erotic in it actually meant that people would be turned off because it's erotica or that it's not erotica. So they felt that the word erotic was a bit strange there. So it got changed to Taking the Heat, which is, you know, a little more generic, but they were quite happy with it. So that was good. For my own titles, sometimes I come up with my own. And sometimes I have my ideal reader or my best friend. Silly publishers, I know. They have their own rules, man. Look, I figure they know more than me and they've been selling books for a lot longer than I have. So I'm going to leave them to do their thing. I have a friend who's also excellent with titles and she helps me out a lot on them as well. They are really tricky. You know, there's kind of a thing about capturing what you want to say about the entire book in kind of one little sentence or paragraph, you know, as short as you can make it. I'm glad Erotic Island was the first. I'm glad there are still a few people around who'd read Erotic Island while it was still Erotic Island, which is really cool. 30 Lays and 30 Days. It's one of my favorites. I love that book. Sorry, I've just relocated my cat because she's trying to knock things off my wall. It's my little writing buddy. I love 30 Days. I'm really proud of it. For those of you who've read it, the sequel, which is 32 Lays Later, is coming out in, hey little Simmy, is coming out in September. And that one, it's hot. I say that with total humility, but yeah, we kind of up the ante on the sexy. So if you enjoy sexy books, I hope you really enjoy 32 Lays Later, which will be out in September. It's available for pre-order now if you're one of those people that likes to load things up on your Kindle and then get surprised when they suddenly appear there. So it's really good. Any more questions, guys? I feel like we're going to wrap up pretty soon. I think the lag is probably affecting a few things here and there. Thank you for spending time with me this morning. What I love about your books is my female characters have their sexuality and are not naive. I love the title of The Curves Ahead. Yes, the picture is noted. That was a journey I had to make, Scarlet, with characters, to make them not naive. I think especially with young adult fiction, and there's a lot of like a tendency to write really weak female characters. And, you know, I think that kind of taps in a little bit to, you know, as women, you know, we kind of, there's a part of us that kind of wants to be rescued and looked after and all that sort of stuff. But at the same time, I mean, you know, realistically, we live in a world where you may not always get rescued by a prince. And, you know, let's face it, it's kind of more fun to kick ass ourselves. Thank you, Lily. I love my readers. I love writing strong female characters. You know, I am... hey, Pepper. You know, the people that know me would say that... I think they would say, I don't know, we can ask Simmy, that I am a strong female character myself. So it would be really hard to write anything that wasn't that way. Yeah, it was funny. I was chatting with my hubby the other day, the love of my life, and saying something about a friend who's going through some stuff with her husband. And he looked at me and he just went, "You would never put up with that, would you?" And I just went, "No." But, you know, he knows that. And we have that kind of crazy, stupid love that I write about. You know, that's why it's in my books. It's because I have it and I've experienced it. And I'm so incredibly blessed in that situation. Dylan, you said something about curves. Are they independent? I own who they are. I'm not embarrassed about it. Yeah, I don't think we have to be. It's not in like an arrogant way at all. It's more so just about, you know, owning who we are and living in a world that is modern and does demand us to do. I mean, you look back even 30, 40 years ago, I mean, women, they were more likely to stay at home. They were more likely to do, not necessarily have to be really independent or think a lot about what they wanted to do as far as career-wise. And that's not really where we live anymore. We live especially in Western countries, and I don't know, I think we have Ireland, UK and US on right now, but for Western countries, certainly it's really hard to support a household or a family on a single income. So you have to work, so you have to be independent, so you have to have kind of that spirit of owning who you are and being able to take it out into the world, which I really love. So that's good. All right, so backtracking. Someone said something about Curbs Ahead. So yeah, that was one of my all-time favorite books to write. And yeah, Dylan loved the title and the journey and her body. Lol. Yeah, so it was fun for me. I wrote that book while I was studying to be a yoga teacher. And I incorporated a lot of what I learned throughout that. And I just, that book has so much of my heart in it. Which is kind of crazy. It still has not found a publisher as yet. So I'm hopeful that it will eventually. If it doesn't, I've made a pledge to myself, by the end of next year, I will look at doing an independent print release. And so I would just get it edited professionally and then do like a limited print release for anybody who actually wanted a hardcover copy of the book. But that's still silly publishers again. It will be published, I hope, so soon. We'll see. So yeah, it'll be interesting to see the journey with that one. Someone said something about Rich Girl, Poor Girl. I also really enjoyed writing that one. Written at a time where money, Dylan wants one. I'll send you one, babe. That's all good. Yeah, I wrote Rich Girl, Poor Girl when we were going through some stuff with some money as well. Generally, a challenge. I channel whatever I'm going through into my books, and it's kind of my therapy, which is really good. Hey, the guys who've just joined us, how did I come up with the idea for Rich Girl Poor Girl with the twist? I'm such a sucker for a twist. Oh my God, I love twist endings. Even if I don't actually like the twist, I adore the idea that a writer has spent time and invested time and thinking about what is actually going to happen at the end right at the beginning. And with Rich Girl Poor Girl, no, I'm not going to kiss you, thanks tree blood. Yeah, that I wanted to invest a lot of time thinking about the storyline. And it also comes from part of my heart and my journey, because thinking about, and I some of you will be younger, but certainly for anyone who's in their mid to late 20s, that you can feel like a different person in your late 20s than maybe you did in your late teens. So how you feel at 27 is very different to how you feel at 17. You can actually, like, literally always be a completely different person. block him. He's not gonna get kissed. He doesn't bother me. The real readers are here. That's all that matters. So yeah, it was this idea that you could be literally a different person at a different time in your life, but how would that combine when the two things came together? So character names. That's a good question. Sometimes I have a few baby name places like on my tabs on my computer, so I can bring them up. Often I'll look up something by meaning and try to find it so that it loosely associates. The name Eviana, I think I'd seen a variation of it and I kind of changed it a little bit. That's okay. Can apologize. Yeah, I changed it a little bit to come up with that. But Heather's last name meant, and I can't remember what it is off the top because I have so many characters running around in my brain. But Heather's last name was an Irish word that basically meant like change or transformation. And I really love that, and so that was her surname. But yeah, they are hard. You kind of have to have them to fit. Bye, Scarlett. Thanks for dropping by. I like character names. I like girly names for girls generally, and I like male names for men. And that's just because as a reader, I find it really confusing if I'm reading a character that I can't identify really quickly, like especially in a summary. If I'm not sure if I'm reading, say, like gay fiction, because it sounds like two male characters, and it's not until you get a pronoun in there, you're like, oh, okay, so it is a girl, which is absolutely fine, but I just really like clarity around what I'm reading first. So that's generally where the drive for my character names comes from. And yeah, in Rich Girl, Poor Girl, I love the name Sparrow. I think it's super cute, and that was why I used that one there. Guys, I think I'm gonna sign off now. If you've enjoyed today, please leave me some hearts on the screen. That would make me feel awesome. Thanks so much for joining me for Where I Write. You can catch me, I think most of you who are here, my regular readers, you can catch me on Facebook and Twitter, both under Kate J. Squires. See you soon on Wattpad. I love Sparrow too. And yeah, you can find my books anywhere that you get your ebooks from. And feel free to reach out at any time on social media and have a chat. It's been lovely having you all here. Thank you to Wattpad and hashtag WhereIWrite. And I will see you all soon. Thanks, guys. Hearts. I love the hearts.